morning, everybody. I am Dimitris Mavidayas, Press and Media. The delegates from various colleges across the state and beyond the state. And we are very much thankful to Vishwa sir and Shanta Gautam madam for accepting your invitation and coming to the place like Warangal. We have a lot of speakers coming from different parts of the country and different blends of technocrats from different fields. So it's a blend and it's a hybrid structure which requires for a student. We have different kinds of speakers. We are very lucky to have such kind of expertise, energetic young speakers like madam, expertise speakers like Vishwa sir. So you have people from IITs, NITs, you have from industry, you have somebody representing innovations from government. So I request everybody not to learn something but get motivated by this program. We cannot teach anything here, but we can only motivate from these 2 days. We have been doing such kind of programs since many years, since our inception. Our chairman sir is a forerunner in this kind of thing. Whenever something new thing comes, we will be here to educate our students. We have done the same thing, couple of months back in civil engineering on recent trends in civil engineering with blend of experts from government sector, industry and academia. So it was a very good successful program that has given us motivation in conducting this program. One thing we should believe, now with the changes, the dynamic changes, the rapid changes. The mobile has started in US, I think. I am from electronics background, so in 1970s or so. But it has come to India in 1990s. But we have become largest customer base for mobile and cheapest services are available in India. So the technology we are using, the 3G to 4G, it was a rapid growth, and the data speeds we are using, the cheapest possible rates. You see how India is prosperous. We have huge human resource here. We have used the talent resource here. The people CEOs of different companies, the famous MNCs are from India. So why can't we have companies from our own children? That will create a huge financial base for the country. So artificial intelligence, as the Charles Darwin's theory comes, struggle for existence. When computers come, everybody worried. We are seeing lot of debates that whether the computer, when computers were coming, there was a lot of discussion whether jobs will go. Jobs have not gone, jobs have been created. So it has been created in a different sector. Now when artificial intelligence comes, when will the machines substitute or replace humans? No. It will not replace, it will aid humans in processing the data in a faster manner. Just like computer revolution has come, now with artificial intelligence revolution, and we are very happy that coincidentally we did not think about it, but once the time has come, we have applied for BTech artificial intelligence from next academic year. And we are also planning to have honors degree in computer science and electronics and different branches with machine learning specialization, IoT specialization, data science specialization. So we are here to bring you up to the highest possible standard. So it should be a vice versa. We expect the same thing from the faculty and students, to raise your bar and don't go beyond the world. You are very good at academics, try to improve your academics, and the people who are coming from other colleges, I thank everybody. So try to spread out the theme of this Congress and try to elevate artificial intelligence. Thank you.